shit. Sarah.
Yep, I'm coming in a minute.
Even though we're missing half of our crew, thank you guys for coming out, making this happen. Enjoy the ride.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Hawaiian Railway. I'm Steve Venn. I'm the operations manager here. I just want to say thank you for coming out. I appreciate it. I am an old car guy from many years ago, but I didn't have those cars with bow ties. I had those old ones. More old Mustangs than I can count, some old 57 T-Birds, and a whole bunch of other stuff. Anyway, you guys have a fun ride. Enjoy yourself, enjoy your day out here at the railroad, and thanks for coming out.
Hello, everyone. My name is Mike. I'm the narrator today, also the conductor. Before we get going, I got a few rules you need to share with everyone. First rule, very important, please remain seated throughout the entire ride. This is a very important rule. If you look down, you'll see why. You'll see our lovely wooden floorboards. If you're standing up and we have to make a sudden stop, you have to put this either your nose or your cole. And we do not have tweezers. Our second rule, related to the first, no smoking on the train. You go through some brush fire prone areas, and again, the cars are made out of wood. Wood burns. You do not want to be the one passenger puffing on a cigarette as everybody else has to walk back to the station due to a brush fire, or running from your life from an angry train crew who's not out of work because of a train fire. Might be fat, but not fast. Our third rule, please keep everything you wish to keep inside the car, such as your head, your hands, your feet, your expensive cell phones and cameras. Even if you don't wish to keep it, like your little brother or sister, please keep it inside the car anyway. You can get rid of it later. I know a guy. And now that we're all ready, I'll give you all clear and we shall head on out. Alright, now the locomotive that has put us today is engine number 302. She is a 300 horsepower diesel electric locomotive built by a company for the US Navy. And she weighs in about 45 tons. Her job for the Navy was to act as a switching locomotive. This means she'll move cars around the yard, as well as some of them into trains or large locomotives to haul. On the Mackay side, we have our train yard for the various pieces of equipment for the machinery. Most of our rolling stock comes from the US Army and Navy. We have a few black cars, box cars, and a couple of big tankers. Our rep train is painted in yellow. We use this to repair the tracks, as well as do routine maintenance and track inspections. We also have our stockpile of wooden ties and steel rails, very important on the railway to keep things up and running smoothly. Now the cars you're sitting in are from the Army and Navy flat cars. When you add sides to a flat car, it becomes a gondola.
Right here.
And when you add a roof, it becomes a long bar car to the hot Hawaiian sun or a slight bar car to the rain. On the mountain side, we have a lovely big construction fence. On the other side of this fence is a white coral pit. White coral, you see a lot of construction here on the islands. We have ourselves and there's ballast for our tracks. If you're looking down our tracks right now, not that you can't see it with a glass bottom train, you will see white rocks when you place wooden ties. These wooden ties when you place steel rails, and these steel rails hopefully hold the train in place. Hopefully. Now the reason for this construction fence, they are filling this coral pit in to be used for a shopping center. Originally they had planned to use the pit as the underground parking, but they changed their mind for some reason. So as soon as this is filled in and they start building, they're going to build it'll be similar to the Alohana and Pearl Ridge shopping centers. Hotel here, which doesn't make sense at all. More commonly found throughout the islands. The reason for that rich red color is because the high iron content in the lava rock that been composed of the islands. The reason for that rich red? I'm sorry. Side is formerly Barber's Point Naval Air Station. Barber's Point was shut down in the late 90s, partly based on Land Act. The land was turned back over to the state, renamed the area Kalaroa Community. The land became what it is now, and the airfield became a civilian airport, which now hosts the Coast Guard's airport operations, as well as a few private hangars, commercial operations. So if you wish to go to another island, you do not want to go to Honolulu International, you can come down here instead. Now this is the dry side of the island, the occasional downpour. The only things that would have been saw by these sugarcane fields, they would have just soaked up all that water, got up nice and big. Nowadays, you know, houses like sugarcane, that comes a bit of a problem, as your house not soaking up water very well. At least not in a good way. So the city built a similar system of drainage to the roadways to lead to this canal. This canal does not lead to the ocean, so once it fills up, you have to wait for it to dry out. On the crossing side, we read in Hawaii, they would read Akahele Ike Kalahi, which roughly chimes in, it's called for the fire car. And that was a pretty accurate description of the early cold wintering up was as the equipment had been on fire. Akahele is also the name of the society's newsletter, so if you become a member of the society, that's what you'll get in your mailbox every month. Central air conditioning. It first opened its doors in 2001, as first graduating class 2004, completed construction in 2006. We had to go through a lot of construction sites to get through different classrooms, and they did not give us hard hats. Some of us did not make it. We are slowing down to a stop. It's because we're at our first cross of the day, 4th Bryant Road. Since all but one of our crosses are not protected, this means that we don't have the flashing light or lowering gates you see on the mainland or in the movies. We're going to have to stop our train. Our crew members will have to come down the ground and stop traffic for us. Once traffic is stopped, we'll then proceed through the crossing at a safe speed, pick up our crew, and be on our way. Now when we go through the cross, I like to encourage everybody to smile, wave, give the shaka as we go through. I hope everybody knows how to shaka. If you don't, make a fist, stick out your pinky thumb.
He said make shaka. How you make shaka? Oh, you know how? Okay, cool.
I learned.
Can I get arthritis? Yeah. Teacher, please remain seated.
This is raining
cheap.
Now on the Mackay side is the new FBI office. This is built on here to help decentralize services away from downtown, as well as get the FBI a large office to work on. A rather impressive structure, helped to never see the inside of it for various reasons. I told you folks to do the shaka. I did not tell you where the shaka came from or how it came about, I should say. There's many stories on as to how the shaka began, but this one involves trains, so it's all right to everybody. In the 1920s, a man by the name of Potluck worked as a presser for the Gugu sugar mill. His job as presser was to feed salt sugarcane through steel orders or squeeze juice up. Unfortunately, Potluck lost his three fingers on his right hand one day when his hand got stuck in the machine. That's how the shaka sign was born. Something you can't quite see it on the side is Fort Bryant itself. Fort Bryant is a closely fenced site built in the 1930s to help defend the coastline against enemy attacks, or the entire island, I should say. It has two 60-inch guns at 6 inches wide, not 6 inches long, and weighed 153 tons apiece. The ORNL had a hand up construction for it, helped them with delivering the building supplies, as well as those two guns, and a spare track that up to the construction site. Now, when the front was first opened, it had an open fire means that the guns are rotating in a big circle and shooting in any direction. So from this spot in Kapolei, they could shoot off the Wamanai coast, off of the north shore, off the windward side, as well as off of the beach. After the end, they just had to angle the guns up a bit more to shoot over the mountains. Carefully enough now for the officers. Looking for any concrete now, any soil being near the bottom.
$60
on gas.
Well, that guy looks like he spent $100.
And we are now at our next car. crossing of Kalaloa Boulevard.
Yeah.
Kalaloa Boulevard is the capital industrial park, which hosts many Hawaii's heavy industries and businesses.
Where Melvin lives.
Across the street, you have the Star Advertiser Pretty Press. This building houses two German-made regional pretty presses that are 5 stories tall and keep up to 70,000 new service per hour. The advertiser requires up to 1,600 tons of newsprint per month, which are trucked up the road with these trucks you see here. If you think they just use a train, let them know. Side is the Capital Industrial Park, which also many Hawaii's shipping industries and business, including the H Power Plant and the oil refinery. The H Power is going to save by burning a very renewable resource of garbage. This not only helps reduce the amount of garbage that goes into landfill, but also the amount of oil we need to import from part of the oven. Although lately I've been hearing they've been having some problems. They do not have enough garbage to burn, I suppose in the long run that's a good problem to have. Also up there in that field is a crane structure. That is part of the construction yard for the mass transit that's being built on the island, otherwise known as the train. They pre-pour the concrete section of the guideway up there and then truck them up the road to where they're needed to cause traffic. I mean, to be put on the concrete pylons. You have seen these pylons, I'm on your way down here. If you can imagine as few as 15 years ago, I need a son of our tracks, there'd be sugar cane growing here. Coming out and start to the ocean, just a small strip of land between for us. Nowadays, this area is really zoned for development, so we're going to start seeing houses going from mountains down to the sea, which is a small strip of land between for us. So what you're looking at is Kamalei West.
Straight behind us, just so much.
cars. In the old days, in garages, maybe you'll feel 50 cents for a burlap sack of those pods in order to feed your cattle. That was a pretty good way to make some extra spending money in those days, much like how much eating cans is today. Now, as most see, the oak cattle produce a very light, flavorful smoke when it is burnt with very little ash. Now, given it was a whistle stop on the oil, this means that a regularly scheduled stop on a train's roster. Whenever you're too light, you're to stand on the platform and raise a flag or some other signal, the train would stop, pick you up, run the cargo on the platform, take you to the next town, or wherever you're heading to. That being the only remaining whistle stop service left in the United States is Alaska. Alaska Airways operates their whistle stop service the off-putters in Arno, because that will allow off-putters away from civilization. On certain days, they line up next to the tracks, waiting for the train to come by, which will stop, pick them up. They'll then get off at the next town, or they'll buy their supplies for the month. But then wait for the train to come back before jumping back on board, which will take them back to where they got on at, and they should not complete the cycle. And on the Thai side is your first special on our trip today. This is kind of a deep draft tower. This view is on here, you can come first here. Just going to show you how fast they can move down here.
Up there, someplace.
short-lasted train signals. Train signals are used to communicate on railways in a uniform set. Signals have been adopted not only airline but around the world. A few blasts you'll hear from our train, one short blast, the train has come to a stop. Two short blasts, and the train is going forward. Three means it is going in reverse. Five short blasts, an animal scared. We use that to scare animals and people off the track. Five long blasts is an emergency signal. Hopefully you'll never hear that, as it means the train is in trouble. And a little bit early for the final signal, but once we get to this crossing, I want you to pay attention to what you're about to hear. This signal is used by railways around the world to warn cars at crossings that a train is coming that they should stop. As a 45-ton freight locomotive versus a half-ton Honda, you can do the math there. Are we not with the signal crossing today? It's over. Pay attention to what you're about to hear. Please remain seated. Two long blasts, one short, and a long blast aboard. As I said, that's used by railways to warn cars they should stop as a train is coming. Tennis courts would be holding a golf club. Go figure. And on the market side, we have some ALOHA trees. We would like to come to this, tell them these are the pineapple trees. And on down the line, there's some that look more like pineapples, so I'll have to point that out to them. The real prize of the ALOHA trees are the leaves. They can be broken down and into various goods such as bats, hats, wedding, clothing, and even jewelry. By the way, careful on the ALOHA leaves, however, as most varieties are covered in sharp spikes on the edges, they can pierce through a thick leather glove. Hanging out on the Makai side, they're doing well, eating in front of the ALOHA leaves there.
Saturdays.
this great city that is told it up. Have you ever seen another black swan or two at this location as well? Yeah. Now after we go through the crossing, I'd like you to look for the gray smokestack on the other side and follow that down to the top of that hill. Concrete structures that some remains of Fort Arizona. Fort Arizona is just up there the after the attack of Florida. The SS Arizona is now the next place on this hillside to defend the Atlantic coast from enemy attacks. Which is a pretty good spot to put it as on the Mackay side. We have the beautiful blue Pacific Ocean on the beautiful Atlantic coast. Keep an eye out, you might be able to spot dolphins, turtles, or even a whale. If it's small about a green pops down the water, catch your breath of air, it disappears and is a dolphin or a turtle.
Says OMILU'S.
If it jumps into the water, it's black or silver in color. And it does backflips and spins and is a dolphin. If it squashes its tail or jumps out of water and way out to sea, it is a whale. If it jumps out of water into a boat, it is a tortoise sized shark.
I think there's a lot of OMILU'S out there. Oh, look at that. Oh, man.
Thanks
for
the water.
Plenty of stop the train, let us fish for like about half an hour.
Yeah.
Then we can get back on.
Yeah, so we're saying to dry intentionally for that bit of cold water. On the mountain side, we have our main stage of Hawaiian fishing hill. The alternating elements that along the east coast of the county trees are. And the tall grass, we're going to see white coral rock, essentially black coral rock. These two rocks are the offerings of the Hawaiian and the other chieftains. The hill was dedicated. You can also get a slightly better view of Fort Arizona from here. This hillside is said to be complete and hollow, and the tunnels are lined up for our train to go through. Now back to that beautiful blue water. So hot, in fact, they have to pump it out into a clue, which is on the Mackay side of our tracks. course, that one has cooled off to a safe enough temperature. It's dead pumped back out into the ocean, or not quite as far. That one is still fairly warm. One on health store back there. That's a kind of small fish. But it's trapped in this one is somewhat. It's snuggers. Maybe we should have this beach. Right there. You would not want to go swimming there as that rock one is very hot. The rocks are very sharp because it's very small. Not to mention only barbed wire and attack sharks. Stopping wind of Kai Point Power Plant. I'd like to encourage everybody to stand up, stretch the legs, and go fully back to the equipment. We are not yet off the train at this point. If you're off the train, you have to wait for the 1 o'clock ride or catch the bus. That's number 40 bus, 2 couple. So I'll switch sides. Now, a question I have to get asked out here is how much further can we go? Well, you got about another 200 yards before we're missing a bridge. Beyond that, we have a lot of track, bearing their sand and dirt. Trees going up in between our train tracks.
We're not
starting. If Bill Gates stays still interested in our road, the farthest we could go would be the first beach park on Kuli. Although our right-of-way extends all the way to the Lulu Lane of Amnishnipo, which is the not including McDonald's. The reason why we cannot go that far is because...
Having fun? This is kind of fun.
Again, once you find your new seat, please take it. Shut the microphone, take a nap. I'm just kidding. I'm going to start talking about the Oahu Railway Land Company. Since we're by the ocean, I'd like to soften one of these stories of Marcus K. Shurik, who was one of the more famous oral analyst computers at this time. He often tells stories about the rides he would do. One such was a freight run from the Malaya station in downtown Honolulu to the North Shore of Puku and back. This trip would take about 3 hours each way, normally. And on this day, the train crew had shown up with throw nets on their shoulders. After the train passed from Kyle Beach up to the North Shore, the crew positioned themselves on the grooves in order to spot fish. Once they spotted the choice little fish, they certainly engineered to stop the train. They then got down underground, stripped out of their clothes, and ran down to the shoreline to cast nets. Once they put in a good haul of fish, they left them back to the boat to drop off their catch. They then got back on board the train. And dressed back up in their work clothes. Now as the train was going out, the engineer would take turns cutting clean the fish, as well as stuffing them into the steam roller motor. While they're in there, they would still be cooked to perfection. By the time they reached the North Shore, cooking the train was smelling the loveliest steamed fish, and everybody wanted to ride that train. Although nobody could, since this was a freight train, not an Oscar train. On a return trip, they stopped off at a Chinese restaurant in Puli, picked up a large pot of fried rice to go with their steamed dish. Then the crew enjoyed a lovely meal that day on the way home, probably somewhere right around here, throwing fish bones off the side of the train and eating in a race. I'm guessing we got to do that nowadays. want to thank our crew members that have any fishing equipment. For another, we don't have a speaker on board to get the fish on. Although some of our crew members say we can do the same thing by having the fish up the pit boilers, but for the exhaust manifold or the radiator. So that is safe. Now I'm going to put some music on for you folks to enjoy, because my boss says I talk too much. So I'm going to put some music on, and I'm going to jump right here. I'm going to show you how to do it, sorry. Any smaller swans on the boat side again?
I'm gonna need a big one.
Do they have a friend who would start the ornament? He first arrived in Hawaii, he keeps the five as he's still there, where the ship was there. The colonel didn't have, without having much food on the ship. Unfortunately, he started going horseback riding. On Thursday's summer along the ride, he carried from suddenly, he just spooked the horse and threw him off, breaking his leg in the process. While recovering at the hospital, we should look for beginners in these videos. I'm not going to put that note in here for you. We're going to do it first. We've all got the numbers to build up here. And here's our right train route, as those are truck crews. It is painted yellow and black. They have a light on its roof. The event is a weed sparing a truck ever, which is for various right away maintenance away tests. This is Stella. She's seen better days. She's the blue and white locomotive being her turn for restoration. Behind her is engine number 85, one of the three remaining Oregon locomotives in existence. The third being number 12, hiding behind our engine ship. 423 is our sister locomotive. She is currently undergoing repairs after a breakdown a couple weeks ago. In our ship, we have Potluck cars deployed. You've restored private observation course that belongs to the president of the railway. It is also currently undergoing the repair work. But normally we bring it out on the second Sunday of the month, as well as bring it out for charter rides. In our next show, we also have engine 174, a diesel electric locomotive that hopefully we will be using to pull our regular train once we get it repaired. I'd like to remind everyone, please remain seated as we pull into the station. We may have to stop the train suddenly and jostle back and forth up the stools just right. We don't want anybody to get hurt, especially within the last few seconds of the trip. I'll say when it is safe to stand up. So again, please remain seated. It's now safe to stand up and disembark from the train. Thank you all once again for coming out right with us. Once again, have a wonderful rest of the day and a safe journey home. Feel free to explore the yard. Just please don't climb up on anything.
Get back.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's walk towards the point.
Thanks for joining us for...
Yeah, let's go.